Hey, money viewers, Rachel Cook here, small business strategist. And today I'm here to share with you the business crisis checklist that we've been providing to entrepreneurs and small business owners to help them navigate the uncertainty around the COVID-19 crisis. This crisis is impacting small business owners more than probably any other thing we've ever experienced, especially businesses that are directly impacted by stay-at-home orders and non-essential businesses being forced to shut down. So we want to make sure that we are taking action now, that we are being proactive to ensure the survivability of our businesses and ultimately to be able to continue operating or reopen in the future. So the first part of the business crisis checklist is getting into the numbers. We want to make sure we're looking at the revenue coming into your business this month and the future coming months. We need to look at whatever invoices you currently have out that need to be paid, whatever contracts or agreements you have out, and make sure you're going to continue receiving payment from those customers and clients. And we want to look at any recurring payments you have on the books. This is going to be really important. We need to have an understanding of what is already coming in without making any additional sales and ensure that those payments are going to continue coming in. Once we have a handle on the incoming revenue over the next several months, we want to take a look at our expenses. This is a great time to do an expense audit. Go line by line by line and look at every single expense, all the money going out of your business. Now, you might find there are expenses you can eliminate completely. You might find that there are opportunities for you to call and negotiate better rates on some of the expenses that you have. You may also find that there are some expenses, especially things like technology subscriptions for software or things that you use to run your business, that you might be able to pause or downgrade the level that you are at just so that you're not overpaying. Go through line by line and look for any opportunity to cut those expenses so you can keep more cash on hand. Next, we want to look at your cash reserves. Your cash reserves are basically the savings account for your business. So how long will that cash reserves actually fund all of those expenses? Once you have an idea of your cash reserves, your incoming revenue, your outgoing expenses, you'll be able to figure out how long can you stay in business without making any additional sales. That information is going to be crucial because if you're cash flow positive, you can continue taking actions to make sure that your business will survive through this uncertainty. But if you're cash flow negative, we've got to take some drastic action to make sure your business will make it. Now, once you have clarity on your numbers, then it's time to call in all of your support. We need to start picking up the phone and checking in with anyone who you are doing business with. First calls are always to CPAs and lawyers. Your CPA is likely paying attention to all of the news, all of the things that are going to impact you, especially all of the updates coming out around the CARES Act. So get on a phone call with your CPA and make sure you're taking advantage of absolutely everything you might qualify for. Similarly, you want to talk to your lawyer. Contracts are going to be important, and a lot of contracts did not account for a pandemic. So we want to make sure that your contracts are solid. We want to make sure that on your side, if you have any contracts that need to be adjusted or altered for services to make sure that you can continue delivering those services, if you need to change anything about those services, we want to make sure your contracts and terms and conditions are going to be buttoned up to protect you. We also want to review any contracts for anything you are held to. Make sure that you are not going to be in a situation where clients can refund on you or where you're going to be out a lot of money. So get on the phone call with your lawyer and have them review all of your contracts, all of your terms and conditions. Next, we need to call in your finance support. So you want to reach out to any banks or financial institutions where you have credit cards, lines of credit, or small business loans. A lot of them are offering reduced interest rate for a period of time, or even offering to defer payments for a period of time. And this is going to be really, really helpful for small business owners to keep cash on hand right now. And that is going to be the name of the game. You want to start making phone calls to make sure that you are not paying out anything that you absolutely don't have to. If those institutions are offering relief for small business owners, take them up on it so that you can keep that cash on hand. Same thing if you happen to have a brick and mortar physical space for your business. You want to call your landlord, or if you own the space, call your mortgage company. A lot of them are offering relief to small business owners. They're either offering a rent abatement or a period of loan deferment where you don't have to make those payments right now. Now that's going to be on a case-by-case basis, so you don't know if you don't ask. Make sure you're clear on the terms though, because often they are set up where at the end of that period, you have to pay a lump sum. And if you do not qualify for a repayment plan or a loan restructuring, then you might find yourself having to give over a ton of cash up front when that is all finished. So we want to make sure we're clear on any terms that are going to be put in place when you ask for this relief. The next thing is, do you need to lay off employees? Now, this is not fun. No one wants to have to do this. But in a time of uncertainty, it's better to make the decision quickly than to try to retain people when your business truly cannot afford to retain them. Your goal is to keep the business open so that those employees have the opportunity to come back. Check in with your local employment lawyer who can help you navigate these decisions, as there are a lot of opportunities to reduce hours or do partial layoffs where those employees can actually qualify for some unemployment benefits. Again, it's not fun, but you need to make the call sooner rather than later, especially if this is going to be a call that helps you continue running your business. Finally, the CARES Act is something you want to be paying attention to. In the CARES Act, they have made small business loans available in two different ways. There's the Paycheck Protection Loan and the SBA EIDL Economic Impact Loan that might be available to you. The key is going to be getting your applications in, so you will be first in line. Entrepreneurs and small business owners are used to a certain amount of uncertainty, but when the economy is so unpredictable right now, we need to make sure we're taking decisive action and not sitting back to wait and see. The more that you can take these steps, the higher the likelihood that your business is going to be in a position to survive through anything that this challenge throws at us. So let me know in the comments below any ahas, insights, or questions that you might have, and I hope this was helpful.